afternoon to one and all present here. I am Vaishali Singh.
And I am Priya.
And we are from River Yamuna. All right, guys. So can you all recall when was the last time your sleep was disrupted by a news? Anyone?
A news which disrupted your news? Disrupted your sleep,
sleep,
I mean.
Sleep.
Yeah.
Okay, they have guessed. But first...
Yeah. Video.
Next.
इस इलाके की अगर बात करें तो तमाम जो लेबर क्लास है वो यहाँ काम करती है और लोग सुबह से लाइन में खड़े जाते हैं, लोगों से बात करते हैं कि ठंड में लोग यहाँ खड़े हैं, ये बताइए कि ठंड बढ़ गई है बावजूद इसका लाइन में खड़ा होना पड़ रहा है।
नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। ऑल राइट, सो फॉर टुडे आवर टॉपिक फॉर टुडेज प्रेजेंटेशन इज डीमोनेटाइजेशन वॉज अ ग्रेट रिफॉर्म. We chose this topic because most of you think that demonetization was just a political move. But today we'll tell you how it has impacted our economy, matlab how it has good impacts on our economy.
So demonetization means stripping of a currency note as its legal tender. And on 8th of November 2016, our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi declared that all the currency notes of 500 and 1000 will no longer be held in use. And in return, new currency notes of 500 and 2000 were introduced after a few days. But however, this was not the first time when demonetization took place. Earlier in 1978, under Morarji Desai government, all the notes of 5000, 1000 and 10000 were demonetized under the High Denomination Currency Bank Note Act 1978.
The main objectives of demonetizations was flush out black money, to eliminate fake currency, strike on terrorism, to boost digitalization, formal economy.
So now we'll see how it impacted our economy in a positive way. So the first effect on economy was move towards a digital economy. So post demonetization, 86% of the total currency in circulation were held invalid, and because of this move, most people turned towards digital transaction. They started doing digital transactions such as UPI, mobile wallet, etc. And government also seeked opportunity through this demonetization for a cashless economy. And in the first graph, as you can see, we have shown UPI transaction value in crores, UPI unified payment unified payment interface transaction in crores. So as you can see, in 2016 it was very low, it was 0.02%, whereas in 2017 it raised up to 10.48%, whereas in 2018 it went on to 48.23%. In the next graph, it is shown that debit card transaction volume in crores. In 2016, 0.11 debit card transaction took place, and then in 2017, 0.24%, and in 2018, it was 0.33%. In the third graph, mobile wallet transaction in crores is seen. In 2016, 0.07%, in 2017, 0.19%, and 2018, it is 0.34%.
The second effect is boost to financial inclusion initiative. Financial inclusion means the availability and equality of opportunities to access of financial services. So deposits in Jan Dhan accounts doubled to 87,000 crore in 45 days prior to demonetization, and average balance was peaked to 2900 approximately, and you can see the data there. As on September 2014, number of accounts were 5.38 crore, and it rose to 25.82 crore in December 2006, and 229.18 in July 2017.
So the third effect on economy was clamp down on black money, which was the main objective of BJP government. After demonetization, the tax return filing shot up by 25.3%. In financial year 2015 to 16, as you can see, 4.63 income tax return files have been filed in crores. That is, we have shown it in crores. And then in financial year 2016 and 17, 5.57 crores income tax returns have been filed. And then 2017 and 18, 6.85 income tax returns have been filed. So the tax evaders who tried to escape from the tax, they were caught up in this demonetization, and 17.9 lakh individuals' profiles have been investigated whose income tax profile did not match with their bank account which they showed. So this was the third effect.
And the fourth effect is check on hawala transactions. Hawala transaction is basically the illegal type of illegal transfer of money
flowing in the economy.
Without money flowing. And trading of currency happens outside the parallel control financial channels. And that type of transactions that happened between hawala brokers did not had any promissory notes. It went into complete paralysis after demonetization.
Now the fifth effect of demonetization was closure of shell companies. So shell companies were basically dad companies which didn't had any existence as an organization. It didn't had any employees. It just existed as a pen and paper work. And they did had bank accounts. They did had assets, and take place an investment, etc. But they didn't had any existence as an organization. So after demonetization, 2 lakh shell companies were deregistered, which was a very great move. So
now we'll see
the motivations for the decision.
Now we'll see the video of former RBI governor Mr. Urjit Patel, what he said about demonetization.
The motivations for the decision were to deal with the problem of high quality counterfeit notes and unearth black money that may be held in cash. The decision was not and has not been taken in haste, but after detailed deliberations, the consequences that have emanated from that were taken on board, and that's why the planning, the process and the implementation was what it was, keeping in mind that high secrecy had to be maintained.
So yes, now we can see that the decision of demonetization was not taken in haste, and although there were many havocs created in short run, but long run benefits were kept in mind.
The motivations for the decision were
Now we come down to the conclusion. Many people didn't accept a demonetization. They were like, they had to stand in the long queues, but we cannot ignore the long run benefits of the demonetization. And people also said that GDP growth rate fell down from 8 to now it is 7%. So the other factors which contributed to GDP falling down were GST introduction, and then low performance of manufacturing, automobile and agriculture sector. So the conclusion were increased bank deposits, digitalized economy, increased government finances, reduction in terror funding, and cleansed out black money.
Thank you.
Thank you.